Dear student, in this lecture video, we studied about the types of water turbines. What are the types of water turbines used in the hydroelectric power plant? Francis turbine, Belton turbine, Kaplan turbine and then propeller turbine. All the four turbines comes under only two subdivision only. One is reaction turbines, another one is water turbine. Now we detailedly studied about the operation of each type of water turbine. Students, now you see the block diagram. The turbine, that is water turbine. Turbine means water turbine. Classified into two types. One is reaction turbine, another one is impulse turbine. The reaction turbine, that means again, that means two type is there, that is the Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, propeller turbine. All the three turbines comes under reaction turbine. That means the Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, propeller turbine are called as a reaction turbine. The Belton turbine or Belton wheel turbine is called as a impulse turbine. This is the classification of water turbine. Now we detailedly studied about the each type of the water turbine. First, generally we studied about the reaction turbine. Reaction turbine. You see, the reaction turbine consists of this is the water from penstock. This arrow mark, this blue arrow mark is nothing but the water flow from that means reservoir to turbine through penstock. Okay, this is nothing but the spiral casing. This is the runner blades. This is the guiding vanes. Now you see the function. In the reaction turbine, the energy, that is both kinetic and pressure energy, both. Okay, the example is tubular, bulb or propeller or Francis turbine. Okay, both are having both energy. Okay, in reaction turbine, the water enters the wheel under pressure and flows over the vanes. Okay, the water flowing over the vanes is under pressure. So therefore, the wheel of the turbine runs full and may be, that means, submerged below the tail rise or may discharge into the atmospheric. Okay, so the pressure head of the water flowing over the guide vanes is converted into velocity head and finally it is reduced to the atmospheric pressure before leaving the wheel. This is the general concept of the reaction turbine. The next, impulse turbine. Now you see the image. Okay, impulse turbine consists of what? That is a penstock. This is the nozzle. This is the spear, this is the hand wheel, this is the runner, this is the elliptical shape is nothing but the bucket of the turbine. Okay, in the impulse turbine, the energy is in the form of kinetic form only, but reaction both kinetic and pressure form. Here what are the turbine? Impulse, Belton wheel turbine and then turbo wheel turbine. Okay, so in the impulse turbine, the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy by passing the water through the nozzle. You see, water from reservoir to the nozzle through penstock only. So that because of the nozzle only, that means the kinetic energy, that means the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. After that, the water falls on the bucket of the turbine, then the turbine rotates. Okay, so therefore the kinetic energy converted into mechanical energy. This is the general concept of impulse turbine. Then the first type, Francis turbine. This turbine is comes under reaction turbine. Now I put the three different images for Francis turbine for understanding purpose only. Okay, now you see the Francis turbine, that consists of a penstock, alternator, that is generator, guide vanes, spiral casing, draft tube, tail rise. This is the head rise. This is the runner of the blade. Okay, so the water from reservoir to turbine through bend stroke. Here valve is there. If the valve open, the water enter to the runner of the turbine. So therefore, that means what? The runner of the turbine rotates. That is the water flow. That means the kinetic energy of the water flow drives the turbine, which converts mechanical energy. The turbine coupled with alternator, then the turbine drives the alternator, then the alternator generate electrical energy, then the water comes to tail race through draft tube. So this is the construction of the Francis turbine. Okay, so what are the point I told here? You see, the water, water enter the turbine is nothing but the in the radial direction. Water enter the turbine, that is through outer periphery, that is the radial direction. If leaves the runner, is nothing but the axial direction. Two direction is used. That's why this type of the turbine is called as the mixed flow turbine. The power developed partly due to velocity of water, then again the difference in the pressure which is acting on the front and back of the runner buckets. Bucket means elliptical shape. In this, in the Francis turbine, the water gets over the blades with small velocity and exerts pressure. The water flow radially, that means radically inwards, and changes to downward reaction while passing through the runner. Okay, this is the important technical points of the Francis. Again, the Francis turbine, that means the water is passes over the rotating blades of the runner of the Francis turbine, both pressure and velocity of water, which is reduced to cause the reaction force, which is used to drive the turbine. The water is discharged through the tail race through a closed tube of increasing cross section, which is called as the draft tube. Already we seen in the diagram. The guide blades or the guide vanes are each pivoted about an axis in parallel with the turbine axis, so that the quantity of the water entering the turbine may be regulated by tuning them simultaneously. The Francis turbine is most suitable for medium head. Medium head means what? Medium head means generally above 30 meter and then below 300 meter. But the Francis turbine is used between the water head 40 meter to 400 meter. Okay, then we studied about the next turbine. The next type is the Belton turbine. Now you see the image of the Belton turbine. This is the bend stroke. Then this is the water flow. This is the bucket. This is the bucket of the elliptical shape is the bucket of the turbine. You see here clearly. This is the water from reservoir to turbine through bend stroke. The outer one is the casing. The elliptical shape is nothing but the bucket of the turbine. So here two nozzle is used. One nozzle, that means enter water from bend stroke to turbine, that nozzle. Another one is brake nozzle, that is the flow from main pipe. So two nozzle, this is the tail race. Okay, this is the diagram of Belton turbine. This is the image of Belton turbine. Okay, the Belton turbine consists of a rotor which is equipped with the elliptical shaped, which is called as a buckets, along the periphery of the turbine, that is the outer one. The rotor of the runner is made up of cast steel, bronze or stainless steel. The water impinges on the turbine, which causes the motion of the rotor, and then the quantity of the water discharged is controlled by the controlling the nozzle opening by means of the needle placed in the nozzle tip. The movement of the needle is controlled by the governor. These are the things like we already studied about in the governing of water turbine, same principle. Okay, the important key points I highlighted with red and green colors. Okay, then when the load on turbine reduces, the governor pushes the needle into the nozzle, thereby it reduces the quantity of water sticking buckets. Okay, if load reduces, automatically the reduces the quantity of water also. So the majority type of the belt and wheel turbine is a horizontal shaft type only. It has two nozzles already we are seen in the diagram. The buckets, that is the elliptical shaped buckets, are bolted onto the runner of the turbine, but integral casting of the buckets with the runner is also possible. Belt and turbine is not suitable for water head below 200 meter. Above 200 meter only we are using this type of turbine. Then Kaplan turbine. Now you see the image. Kaplan turbine. Kaplan turbine, you see here two chamber. This is the head race. The another one is a tail race. See, similarly both diagram you have to compare. Okay, the middle portion, you see the middle one is nothing but the propeller. Okay, so this is the draft tube. Okay, so this is the suction head, this is the effective head. I already told the effective head is the important parameter for the selection of water turbine. Okay, now you see the operation of the Kaplan turbine. The Kaplan turbine is nothing but the reaction turbine. It has gate governing mechanism similar to that of the Francis water turbine. The water flow strikes the blades axially and receives radially. Okay, both directions. The water flow radially inwards through the regulating gates, changing direction in the runner to axial flow and causing reaction force. This reaction force only is used to drive the turbine. But the shape of the shaft which are used in the Kaplan turbine is vertical shape. This turbine has highest specific speed. The specific speed is the one of the characteristics of the water turbine. This turbine is most suitable for low head and large flow plants. That is the based on the water head and then based on the water flow. The runner blades are less in Kaplan turbine. That means 3 to 6 numbers. Minimum 3, maximum 6 runner blades only is used in the Kaplan turbine for generating kinetic energy into mechanical energy. The Kaplan turbine with adjustable runner beds and adjustable gain beds is provided in the Kaplan turbine, which is used to double regulated, because while one with only adjustable runner beds, so the both adjustment is used in the Kaplan turbine. Then we studied about the last one is the propeller turbine. Propeller turbine is comes under what? Reaction turbine only. Now you see both, that means this is the actual inflow, gate van axial outflow. Here only axial flow only is there. There is no axial and radial flow. Only axial flow only. This is nothing but the propeller turbine. You see the arrow mark. Axial inflow like this. After this is the axial outflow. So from gate van, this is the direction of the flow. Okay. Now you see the key points. Okay. So what are the operation of a propeller turbine? The propeller turbine most suitable for low head application. That means below 30 meter water head. But the propeller turbine head is 10 meter or less than the 10 meter only. It is comes under low head. Axial flow reaction type turbine. This is called as axial flow. Only axial in and out only is there. There is no radial flow. In the propeller turbine, there is no provision for changing the runner blade angle. I already told, you know, the Kaplan turbine, the runner blade adjustment and then gate vans adjustment line is available. But here there is no provision for changing the runner blade angle while the turbine is in the motion. So such type of the turbines, the blades are made up of cast integrally with the hub. Okay. And then the construction of propeller turbine is very simple and then easy, but its efficiency falls sharply at reduced load. Whenever the load is decreased at that time, that means the efficiency of the propeller turbine is reduced. Okay, so therefore the such type of the turbine is running with fully loaded for efficient operation only. Dear student, in this lecture video, I hope that all of you clearly understand the operation of the types of water turbines, that is Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, Propeller turbine, belt and wheel turbine, then why it is called the reaction turbine, why it is called the impulse turbine, where it is used, everything we studied, and then image also you are seeing. From this you can get one idea from the image. Oh, this is a Kaplan turbine, this is Propeller turbine, this is the Francis turbine, this is the belt and wheel turbine. Thank you students for listening this video.